Hey guys, welcome back again. So today in this class, we are going to see exercise 1.1 of real numbers. Already we have discussed the introduction part as well as the theorems and example problems. So in this video, we are going to see exercise 1.1 problems. Okay, so without wasting any time, just get into the video. So for our question is, express each number as a product of. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we are going to discuss mathematics real numbers exercise 1.1 problems. Okay, already we have seen the introduction part, the theorems and the example problems in the previous videos. If you want, you just go and check it out, that then you come back to this video. Okay, without the basic information of these real numbers, it's very difficult for you to understand. That's why please watch that video and then come back again. Okay, so without wasting any time, let's get into the video. So our question is, express each number as a product of its prime factor. So prime factor are nothing but prime factorization we have to do. Okay, so let's start with the first one. Here 140 is given, so let's see the prime factorization of 140. So 2 sevens, 2 zeros. Okay, then 2 threes, 2 fives, then 7 fives, after that 5 ones. So therefore 140 prime factorization will be 2 into 2 into 7 into 5. So these are the prime factorization, these are the prime factorization of 140. Okay, let's see the second question. Here 156 is given. So let's do this one also. So 156, so it's prime factorization. I already told you in the previous videos also, start with the smallest prime number. Okay, so 2 is the first one, means 2 is the smallest prime number. That's why we have to start with a 0 always. That's why we have to start with 2 always. So 2 sevens 14, 2 eights are 16, then 2 threes 6, 2 nines 18, then 3 ones 3, 3 threes 9, then 13 ones 13. Therefore 156 prime factorizations are 2 into 2 into 3 into 13. Okay guys, now we'll see the third one. Okay, so what is the question here? 3 8 2 5. Okay, so let's do this. Okay, say always start with 2, but here 5 is the odd number, just go with the 3. See, 3 ones 3, 3 2 6, 2 will left 22, 3 sevens 21, 1 will left, 3 fives 15. Okay, so here again 12 7 5 is there, that's why this will also go in third table. So 3 fours 12, 3 2 6, 3 fives 15. Just see here 425. 425 will not go in 3 table, but it will definitely go in 5 table. That's why 5 8's 40, then 2 will left, 5 5's 25. Again 85 will go in 5 table. So 5 1's, 5 7's 35. So here 17. 17 is a prime number, it will not go in other table. So 17. So 17 1's 17. Therefore 3825, what are the factors of this 3825? 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 17. Okay, now we'll see the next problem. Here fourth one, so just see here 5005. So here also we are going to do the prime factorization for this. Here by seeing this number, we can easily say that this will definitely go in 5 table, which is a prime number itself. So 5 ones, 5 zeros, 5 zeros, 5 ones. Okay, then here 1 is there at the ending point. So we can say that after 5, then 7. 7 is the prime number, it will definitely go in 7 table. So 7 ones 7, 7 fours 28, then 7 threes 21. Okay guys, then we'll see Here 14, 3 is there. So it will go in 11 table. So 11, 1 is 11. 3 will left. 11, 3 is 13. Then 13 is a prime number. It will go in its 13 table itself. So 13, 1 is 13. Therefore, the prime factorization of 5, 0, 0, 5 are 5 into 7 into 11 into 13. Okay. So now we'll see this problem. Okay. Now we'll see this one. So our number is 7429. Okay. Let's do this. Okay. Let's see the prime factorization of 7429. Okay, here 9 is there,
which is an odd number. Okay,
it will definitely not go in 2 table. Then we'll check 3. 3 to 6, 3 4 is 12. Then 22 means 3 7 is 21, 19, 19. So it will not go in 3 table also. Then check next prime number is 5. 5 table means here in the unit digit we should have 0 or else 5. Then only it will go in 5 table. Then check 7. 7 1 7 0 7 7 6 42, then 9 will left, 9 is not there in 7, so 7 also will not work here. Then next prime number is 11. 11 is also not good. Then 13 is also not good. Then we'll check 17. So 17, let's check it out. 17 7 4 2 9 2 9. Okay, so 17 4 68, right? So 68, then the left will be 62, then 62. 62 is not there in 17. Then 17 3 is 51. So what will left? So 11, then 9 is there. 119 is there in 17 7 7 119, so 0. So this will go in 17 table. So 17 437 437. Okay, so here 437 is there. So 7, it will not go in 3 table. Then it will not go in 7 table. 13 also will not go. Let's check again. 17 17, no, it's, so this will go in 19 tables. See, 19 2 is 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, means 57. 57 is there in 17 table. So 19 3 is 57. Okay, so 23, so 23 is a prime number. So then it will go in 23 table only. Okay, 23 once. Okay guys, like that you have to check it out, all the prime numbers, and you have to do this LCM, means you have to do this prime factorization method. So whenever you just come across all the numbers and you have to do the prime factorization for this, so always check it out with the prime numbers only. Okay, this is a prime factorization method, that's why all the numbers will go with the prime numbers only. Okay, therefore the prime factorization of 7429 is 17 into 19 into 23. So these are the 5 problems. Here we have asked, we have to find out the product of prime factorization method. So product of product is nothing but multiplication. This is the product of prime factorization of this particular number. So this is the prime factorization of this particular number, like this. Okay, let's move on to the second Roman, which is, so let's see the second Roman. Here the question is, find the LCM and HCF of the following pair of integers and verify that LCM multiplied by HCF equal to product of two numbers. Have you observed this one? We already talked this in our previous class. Okay, so I have clearly talked about this in the previous video. If you didn't watch that video, please go and visit that first, then come back to this video again. Okay, so let's start. So our first number is 26 and 91. Okay, first what we'll do, the prime factorization for each number. So first is 26. Let's do this. And you have to start with the smallest prime number, which is 2. So 2 1's 2, 2 3's 6. So 13 is a prime number, then it will definitely go in 13 itself, not with other numbers. Okay, so this is the prime factorization of 26. So like that we have to do with 91 also. So 91. So here 1 is odd number in the unit digit, so it will definitely not go in 2 table. Then 3 also in 3 table it will not go. Then so we have to check the next number, which is 7. Yes, it will go in 7. 7 1 7, then 2 left, 2 will left. 21, 7 3 is 21. Again 13 is there, so as 13 is a prime number, it will go in it in that table itself. So 13 1's 13. So just write it down. The factors of 26 are 2 power 1 multiplied by 13 power 1. Like that, 91 factors are 7 and then 13. So now what we have to do, we have to find out the LCM. How to take out the LCM of the given numbers. So its definition is product of the highest power of each prime numbers, each prime factor. So product of greatest power. So here only 13 is common. But in that also same powers are there. That's why we have to take out all the numbers. That is 2 into 7 into 13. Okay, we have to do the multiplication for this. 7 to 14. 14 into 13. What is, let's do this. So 14 into 13. So sorry guys. So 14 into 13. 4 3 is 12. Sorry. I thought it was 7, 3 is 21. I thought it was 7 here. So this is wrong. Okay. So 4, 3 is 12. Then 3, 1 is 3, 4. Then 4, then 1. Then 2, 8, 1. Then the answer is 182. So then we have to find out the HCF. What is the definition of HCF? So the product of the least power of common prime factor. Here common here in this, we are getting only this one is common. 13 is the common, and in that least power we have to take. But here the powers are same. That's why we have to take the same as 13. So LCM is 182 and HCF is 13. Now we have to verify that LCM and HCF are equal to product of two numbers or not. Okay, let's check. Verification. So we know the formula, LCM multiplied by HCF equal to product of two numbers. Okay, what is LCM value? 182. 182 multiplied by HCF value is 13. So product of two numbers, what are the product of two numbers? Means what are the given two numbers? 26 and 91. So 26 into 91. So here we have to do the multiplication for both the numbers. So 182 into 13. We'll check here. 182 into 13. So 3 2 6, 8 3 is 24, 3 1 3 4 5, then 182, then 6 6, 5 10 13, 2 3 6 6. Okay, 2 3 6 6 equal to, then we have to find the multiplication of this. So 26 into 91, so 1 means 26 itself, then 9 9 6 54, then 9 2 is 18, 19 20 21 22 23. So 23, so 6 6 3 2, so 2 3 6 6. Therefore LHS equal to RHS, hence proved. So this is, our answer is right. So like that we have to do the next, second one and third one. Let's do the second one also. So our question is, so what is our question? B, 5 10 and 92. Okay, let's do the prime factorization of 510. So 2 2's 4 2 5's 10 2 5's 10. Okay, 255 is there, that's why it will go in 5 table, but just it will go in 5 table as well as in 3 table. That's why I'm taking first 3, because after 2 the next prime number is 3. That's why. Okay, 3 3 8's 24 3 5's 15. Okay, now 85 is there, then it will go in 5 table. 5 5 1's 5, then 5 7's 35. So 17 is a prime number, so it will go in 17 table itself. So like that we have to do with 72 also, sorry 92 also. So 2 4's 8 2 6's 12, then 2 2's 4 2 3's 6. 23 is a prime number, so it will go in that table itself. 23 1's 23. So just write it down, the factors of 510, which are 2 into 3 into 5 into 17. Okay, like that 92 factors are 2 into 2 into 23. Okay, so now we have to find out the LCM. LCM, what is the LCM? Product of the highest powers, highest power of each prime number. Here just see, this can be written as 2 power 1 3 power 1 5 power 1 and 17 power 1, and here this will be written as 2 square into 23 power 1. Okay, so LCM will be, here 2 is common, but in that we have to pick the highest power for LCM. So 2 square, next there is no other common number here, that's why we have to take all the numbers, that is 3 into 5 into 17 into 23. Okay, okay, now we have, what we have to do, we have to do the multiplication for this. So 2 square means 4 4 3 is 12 12 5 60, means 60 into 70 17 into 23. First we'll do the multiplication for this, then after that one. So 17 into 23, 7 3 is 21, 3 1 is 3, 4 5, then 7 2 is 14, 2 2 is 2 1 is 2, 3. So 1, 9, 3. So again for that we have to do with 60. We'll take with 6, then for the answer we'll add 0. Okay, 6 1 6, 6 9 is 54. So 6 3 is 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So 2, 3, 4, 6, 0 is our answer. 2, 3, 4, 6, 0. So, this is our LCM. Okay? LCM answer is 2, 3, 4, 6, 0. Now, we have to do the HCF. So, what is the definition of HCF? Product of the least power of prime factors. So, product of the least power of common prime factor. Here common is this only, so here in this both the least power is this, so HCF is 2. So now we have to verify that. Verify. So LCM multiplied by HCF equal to product of two numbers. Okay, so what is the value of LCM? 2 3 4 6 0 multiplied by HCF is 2. Then product of two numbers, what are the product of two numbers? 5 10 and 92. So 92 into 5 10. Okay, now we have to do the multiplication so that we may know whether this is right or not. So 2 0 0 2 6 12 4 2 8 9 3 2 6 2 2 4. Okay, 4 6 9 2 0. So here also we have to do the LCM. So we'll do with 92 into 51. Okay, so 2 1's 2 9 1's 9 5 2's 10 9 5's 45 46 46. This is 0. Okay, so 4 6 9 2 we have to add 0 further. So 4, 6, 9 to 0. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS. So this is proved. Okay, like that we have to do the third sum also, which is 336 and 54. Okay, let's do the third problem, which is 336 and 54. Okay, so let's do the prime factorization of first number 336. So 2 1s, 2 6, 2 8s. Okay, then 2 8 16, 2 4 8. Okay, then 2 4 8, 2 2 4. Then 2 2 4, 2 1 2. Then 21, then 3 7 21, and 7 1 7. Like that, we have to do for 54 also. So 2 2 4, 2 7 14. Then 3 9s 27, then 3 3s 9, then 3 1s 3. So therefore 336 prime factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7, which means 2 power 4 into 3 power 1 into 7 power 1. Like that 54 prime factors are, so 2 into 3 into 3 into 3, which means 2 power 1 into 3 power 3. Okay, therefore LCM, what is LCM? Product of highest power of each prime factor. So here 2 is common and the highest power is 2 power 4. That's why we have to take this. Then in 3, which is the highest factor, 3 cube. Okay, then the next one also we have to write, then 7, right? So 2 power 4 means 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16. Okay, then 3 cube means 3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27 into 7. So now we have to find out the multiplication for these three numbers. First we'll do this. So 16 into 27. 6 7 is 42. Okay, 7 1 7, 8 9 10 11. So 6 2 is 12, 2 1 is 2, 3. Means 2, 3, 4. So again we have to do with 7 table. Then 7 2 is 14, 7 3 is 21, 22, 7 4 is 28, 29, 30. So 3 0 2 4 is the LCM. 3 0 2 4 is the LCM. Okay. Then we have to find out the HCF, which is product of the least power of common prime factor. Here common are only 2 and 3. In that we have to pick out the least power, means 2 power 1, okay, into here least power is 3 power 1, which means 2 3 is 6. So 6 is the value of HCF, 3024 is the value of LCM. Okay, now we have to verify it. Verification. So in verification, we know that LCM multiplied by HCF equal to product of two numbers. So what is the value of LCM? 3024 multiplied by HCF means 6 equal to, what are the product of two numbers? 336 and 54. So 336 multiplied by 54. We have to do the multiplication for this. 6 4 is 24. So 2 is there. 6 2 is 12. 13 14. 1. So 6 3 is 18. 1 8 1 double 4. Equal to here. Here also we have to do the 336 multiplied by 54. Okay. 6 4 is 24. 4 3 is 12. 13 14. 4 3 is 12. 13. Okay. Then 6 5 is 30. 3, 6 5, 6 5 is 30, 3, then 5 3 is 15, 18, then 5 3 is 15, 16. So 4, 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, then 8, then 1. So 1, 8, 1, 4, 4. So LHS equal to RHS. hence proved. Okay guys, these are the three problems in Roman number 2. Okay, now we'll see the Roman number 3. Okay guys, let's see the third question, which is find the LCM and HCF of the following integers by applying the prime factorization method. Here also three numbers are given. For each we have to do the prime factorization. Then we have to find out the LCM and HCF for each, means for each set. Okay, let's start with. So guys, let's do the first problem, which is 12, 15 and 21. So we have to find out the prime factorization for each term. Okay, so start with 12, then 2, 6, 12, okay, then 2, 3, 6, then 3, 1, 3. Next we'll do for 15. So 15 will not go into table, then we'll do with 3, 5, 15. Okay, 3, 5, 15, then 5, 1, 5. Like that for 21, 3 7s 21, then 7 1 7. Therefore, 12 factors are 2 into 2 into 3, which means 2 square into 3. Okay, then 15 factors are 3 power 1 into 5 power 1. Okay, then 21 factors are 3 power 1 into 7 power 1. Okay, now what we have to do? We have to find out the LCM. So, what is LCM? Product of the highest power of each prime factor. So, here only 3 is the common term here. So, then 2 square into 3 into 5 into 7. Which means 2 square. 2 square means 4. 4 3 is 12. 12 into 7 5 is 35. Okay. Now we have to find out this. 12 into 35. 5 2 is 10. 5 1 is 5 is 6. 3 2 is 6. 3 1 is 3. Means 0 2 4. 420. That equal to 420. So LCM is 420. Okay. Now we have to find out the HCF, which is the highest, smallest power of common prime factor. Here only 3 is common, that's why 3 is the HCF. Okay, okay. Then we'll do the second one, which is 17, 23 and 29. Okay, if you look at this, these numbers are the prime numbers, right? So for prime numbers, there are no other factors rather than 1 and itself. So if you do this step also, you will get to see only 17, 23 and 29 itself. So therefore, so for this type of numbers, always remember HCF will be 1. So HCF will be 1. Okay, now we have to find out the LCM. LCM for these three numbers are 17 into 23 into 29. Okay, first we'll do this, then we'll do this. Okay, so 17 into 23. So 7 3 is 21, 3 1 is 3, 4 5, 7 2 is 14, 2 1 is 2, 3. Means 391. Okay, for this again we have to do 29. Okay, 9 1 is 9, 9 9 is 81, 9 3 is 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 30, 34, 35, 35. So 2 1 is 2, 9 2 is 18, okay, 3 2 6, 7. Okay, then 9 3, 5 8 10 is 13, means 10 11. So answer is 1 1 3 3 9. Okay, let's do the third one, which is 8, 9 and 25. Okay, first we'll do the 8, means 2 4 is 8, 2 2 is 4, then 2 1 is 2. Like that for 9. So 3 3 is 9, 3 1 is 3. So then for 25, 5 5 is 25, 5 1 is 5. Therefore, factors of, means prime factors of 8 is 2 into 2 into 2 means 2 into 2 into 2, which means 2 cube. Then prime factors of 9 is 3 into 3, which means 3 square. Then 25 factors are 5 into 5, which means 5 square. Okay? Okay, therefore LCM. What is LCM? Product of the highest power of each prime factor. Here there is no common terms here. So we have to write down 2 cube into 3 square into 5 square. So which is 2 cube means 8, 3 square means 9. 8, 9, 72. Okay, then 5 square means 25. Let's do the multiplication here. 72 into 25. 5, 2 is 10. 7 5 is 35, 36. Then 2 2 is 4, 7 2 is 14. Okay, so 0 0 4 5 6 7 8 1 means 1800. 1800 is the LCM. Okay, then we have to find out the HCF. What is HCF? HCF definition is product of the least power of common prime factors. Here there is no common terms here, so if there is no common terms, then the HCF will always be 1. Okay, therefore HCF is 1, because here I'll write it, because no common prime factors. Okay, that's why HCF will be 1. Okay guys, have you got this? Let's move on to the next question, which is, okay, let's see the fourth question, which is, given that HCF 306 and 657 is 9, find the LCM of 306 and 657. So here this question is nothing but, here we have given two numbers which are 306 and 657. So for this both numbers we have given the answer of HCF, which is 9. So the HCF of these numbers is 9. Now what we have to do? We have to find out the LCM of these numbers. So by seeing this, we can easily say that we can do it by LCM into HCF equal to product of two numbers. So from that formula, we can easily find out the LCM. Let's do that. So we know that HCF multiplied by LCM equal to product of two numbers. Okay. We know that HCF into LCM equal to product of two numbers. Okay, but here given two numbers are 306 and 657, and I will write HCF also here. HCF equal to 9. So what is the value of HCF? HCF is 9 into, we have to find out the LCM. That's why I am putting the same LCM here. Then what are the two numbers? 306 and 657. We have to multiply both the numbers. 657. Okay. Now we have to find out the LCM. That's why I am sending this 9 to that side. Then here it is in the multiplication form. When it go to that side, it will take the division. So 306 multiplied by 657 divided by 9. Okay, so we can cancel out here. So 3 3 is 9, 3 1s, 3 0s, 3 6, 3 2s. Okay, then again 3 1s are 3, 3 3 is 9, 10 3 4s, 12. So we have to find out the LCM. LCM equal to 34 into 657. So we'll do it here. 657 into 34. Okay. 7 4 is 28. Okay. 7 5 4 is 20, 22. 6 4 is 24, 25, 26. Then 7 3 is 21. 5 3 is 15, 16, 17. 6 3 is 18, then 19. Then 8 3, 12, 13, 10, 12. then 2. 2, 2, 3, 3, 8. Therefore, which is 2, 2, 3, 3, 8. Therefore, LCM. LCM equal to 2, 2, 3, 3, 8. So, this is the answer of LCM. Okay, guys. So, this is the answer. Let's move on to the fifth question, which is... Okay, let's see the fifth question, which is, check whether 6 power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. So, by seeing this question, we can remember the example problem which I have discussed earlier in the previous video. Okay, if you didn't watch that video, please go and watch that second video of this chapter where I have discussed the example problem which is related to this. If you understood that, then it's easy for you to solve this one also. So here we have asked, check whether 6 power n can end with a digit 0 for any natural number. So here we have given 6 power n as number where n is a natural number. So, here 6 power n is given where n is a natural number. Here we are asking that. So, here what the question is telling us, is it possible to get 0 in the unit digit when you put 6 to the power any natural number? Will it possible to get 0 in the unit digits? Let's check that. So, if I put 1 which is a natural number, then 6 power 1 means 6. If I put 2 here, 6 square means 36. If I take cube, 6 cube is 6, 6, 36, 36, 6, 2, 1, 6, and so on. So, whatever I am taking upon the power of 6, I am not getting 0 in the unit digits, means in the last digit. Because to get 0 in the last digit, we should have the combination of 2 and 5 as prime factors. Okay, so we have to get the prime factors of 2 and 5. Let's see. So, if I do the prime factorization for 6 power n, let's see what happened. So, prime factorization of 6 power n will be, so this 6 can be written as 2 into 3 power n. Which, so this is in the form of a into b power m, which is a power m into b power n. So 2 power n into 3 power n. So to get 0 in the unit digit, we must have the combination of 2 into 5 means 2 and 5 prime factors. So to get 0 in the unit digit, to get 0 in the unit digit, we must and should have 2 and 5 as prime factors. But here we are getting 2 and 3. So 2 and 3 we are getting as factors. That's why it's impossible to get 0. So therefore 6 power n will never be 0. So this is the answer. Okay, guys. Let's move on to the next question, which is question number 6. Explain why 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5 are composite numbers. So before going to solve this question, let me tell you what are composite numbers. So do you know what are composite numbers? I have already discussed this in the introduction part of this chapter. Okay. You just go and watch that first video of this chapter, which is an introduction part of real numbers. So in that I have discussed the composite number. Okay, here I'll tell you lightly. So composite numbers are those numbers which are greater than 1 and which is divisible by 1 itself and with the other numbers. Means for composite number we have more than 2 factors. Okay, that is 1 itself and other numbers as well. So here I'll write. So first we have given 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13. So if you see this, so this is treated as one first term. So this is treated as second term. So this plus is this plus is dividing it in two terms. So what is common here? If you see the first term and the second term, what is common? 13 is the common. That's why I am taking 13 out. So if I take 13 as common, then the left part is 7 into 11. Then here plus is there. That's why plus. I have already taken 13 out. That's why 1 is left. So 13. 7 into 11 is 77 plus 1. Okay. So 13 into 77 plus 1 means 78. So now we have to prove that is it a composite number or not. Yes, of course this is a composite number. Why? I have already told you that composite numbers have more than 2 factors, which are, so I will write down here. So composite numbers have more than 2 factors. Okay. So that is, it is divisible by 1. Okay. 1 itself and with other numbers. So here if you just see here, so 13 into 78 can also be split out. So 13 is a prime number, that's why we can't split this 13. Then 78 we can split it as 2 into 2 3 6 2 9 18. So here already 3 factors are there. Again, if I take into 1, if I add 1, then it is more than 3 factors. It is more than 2 factors. Means here we are getting 4 factors. That's why this is a composite number. Okay. Okay. So let's see the second one. Okay. What is second one? 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. Okay. 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 Just see in this question. So up to this, this is first term. Okay. And this is second term. Okay, what is common here? 5 is common. Okay, if I take 5 out, then the leftover will be 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Again, here 1 is already there. Okay, plus 1. Okay, now we have to find 5 into 7, 6 is 42. Multiplied by 4, 3 is 12, 12, 2 is 24. Okay, plus 1. So first of all, we'll just multiply 42 into 24, which will be 4, 2 is 8, 4, 4 is 16. Then 2, 2 is 4, 4, 2 is 8. 8, 10, and then 10. 1, 0, 0, 8. So 5 into 1, 0, 0, 8. Plus 1. Okay. So this will be 5 multiplied by 1009. So this is also a composite number. But you may get a doubt that, ma'am, this is 1009 is a prime number. Then how do you say that this is a composite number? Why I'm saying, just see the definition. Composite numbers have more than two factors. It is divisible by one itself and with other numbers. So here already two factors are there, five and itself. Then it is, every number is divisible by one. So now just see, it is more than two factors. Therefore, so more than two factors. That's why, hence, this is also a composite number. Cleared, guys? Now we'll move to the next problem, that is the last problem of this exercise. So guys, let's see the last question. So our question is, there is a circular path around a sport field. Okay, Surya takes 18 minutes to drive one round of the field, while Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. Suppose they both start at the same point and at the same time and go in the same direction. After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? So let's see the answer. So in the question, we have one circular path. Suppose this is a circular path. And we have two persons named Sonia and Ravi. And this is, suppose this is the starting point. Okay, this is the starting point where Sonia and Ravi have started to cover this circular path. Okay, so Sonia takes 18 minutes to cover this one round and Ravi to cover this one round. So then the question is asking us, if they have started at the same point and at the same time, okay, and in the same direction, okay, suppose in this direction they are moving. So now we have to find out, after how many minutes will they both meet at this starting point. Okay, let's see. Answer. To cover one round, Sonia takes 18 minutes. Okay, so to cover one round, Ravi takes 12 minutes. Now we have to find out, after how many minutes will they both reach at the same starting point. So for that, we need to find out the prime factorization of both numbers. So first, we'll do the prime factorization of 18. So 2 9's 18. So 3 3's 9. Then 3 1's 3. Like that. For 12 also we have to do. So 2 6 12. 3 2 6. Then 2 1's 2. So therefore, 18 factorizations are 2 into 3 into 3, which means 2 power 1 into 3 square. Okay. Then for 12, 2 into 3 into 2, which means 2 square into 3 power 1. So now to find out, after how many minutes will they meet again at the same point? For this, we need to find out the LCM. So LCM of 18 and 12. So what is the definition of LCM? Product of the highest power of each prime factor. Here 2 is common and 3 is common. But in the common, what we have to pick? We have to pick out the highest power. So we have to take 2 power 2 and here 3 power 2. Means 2 square and 3 square. Means 4 into 9, which is 9 fourths 36. Means 36 minutes. So, therefore, Ravi and Sonia, or else Sonia and Ravi, takes 36 minutes to meet at the starting point. So, or else you can write it as after 36 minutes, after 36 minutes, Sonia and Ravi reach or meet at the starting point. Starting point. Okay. So this one is better rather than that. So after 36 minutes, Sonia and Ravi meet at the starting point. So guys, this is the entire exercise of 1.1. I hope you all understood this class well. If you like it, guys, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. If you still have any doubt, don't hesitate to comment me below. If you have any queries to ask me, please join me on WhatsApp and there you can ask me your queries. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye, take care.